Static members, such as variables and methods, are members that are shared across all instances of a class. Furthermore, static members can be accessed directly from a class without instantiating an object of the class first. Normally, member variables are unique to each object of a class. While every object of a class has the same variables, they each have their own values. With static variables, however, each object of the class has the same variable with the same value. Therefore, changing the value of a static variable in one place will result in a change of value in all of the others. Say that you wanted to know how many objects of an enemy class had been instantiated. An easy way to accomplish this would be to use a static member variable named enemyCount. By putting the keyword static in the declaration of a member, you are declaring that it is static and thus will belong to the class itself, not any instance of the class. Then, all you need to do is increment the variable whenever an enemy object is created. Since every object increments the same variable, it will contain the total number of all enemies created. Accessing the static variable is also a fairly simple endeavor. Here, we have a game class that creates a few enemies. To find out how many enemies were created, we simply need to access the enemyCount static variable by using the class's name and the dot operator. In this case, the enemyCount variable equals 3. This process works for scripts intended to be game object components as well. For example, if we wanted to know the number of players created in a scene, we could create a player script component. In this script, we could declare a static player count variable, and in the start method, we could increment it. Now, anytime a game object with this script attached to it is created, the total player count increases. In another script component, we can access this static variable using the name of the script and the dot operator. Just like static variables, static methods are methods that belong to the class and not a specific object of the class. A very simple example of this would be if you have a class called Utilities, and inside the class you have a static method called add that returns the result of adding two numbers together. You can tell that the method add is static by the static keyword in front of it. Now in another class, you can call the add method using just the name of the class and the dot operator. You do not need to instantiate an object of the class to use its static members. Chances are, you have already used static methods even if you haven't realized it. Consider any time you have worked with input in Unity. Methods like input.getAxis, input.getKey, and input.getButton are all static methods. You can tell that they are static because you didn't need to instantiate an object of the input class in order to use them. In fact, Unity has many static methods available to you that provide a wide assortment of utilities and features. It is important to note that you cannot use non-static class member variables inside of static methods. Remember that a static method belongs to the class, while non-static variables belong to the instances of the class. You can also make an entire class static. To do so, simply put the static keyword in front of the class name. The result is that the class becomes static and cannot have instances of it created. This is useful if you wish to make a class completely made up of static member variables and methods, like the input class.